Sorry about all the technical bullcrap. Oop. So, yeah. This is Momodora, Reverie Under the Moonlight. It is the fourth Momodora game. I guess Parker will not be leaving tonight. I guess he's just gonna sit right here in my way. Thank you. I played Momodora 3. I've been meaning to play the whole series, but I kinda... I don't know. I got slightly stuck in one. Can I delete this? Yeah, I just started that to make sure the game worked. So, as an introduction, Momodora is a series of slightly cave story, slightly Castlevania, slightly Metroidvania style games. Everyone likes to compare it to Dark Souls. I don't. But it's obvious the actual developer really loves Dark Souls, so I guess it's a reasonably valid, you know, comparison in this case, but I still don't like comparing things to that because, I mean, it's just too obvious. But, very good games, very good pixels. The first two games are free. They're not as good, they're not as long, I don't think. But, you can find them on, I think it's just like Momodora.com, or I forget what it is. But if you just Google search Momodora, you'll find it. Beam doesn't work for you? Have you mailed the Beam team about that, or like, contacted them? I haven't. Some people seem to have issues with Beam, and Beam said they have some intermittent connectivity issues, but, I guess I'll just go with the default. Go away, Mr. Mouse. I forgot what I was saying. That's right, Parker. I've been meaning to play the whole series, but, it just so happens that Momodora 4 is, on sale on chrono.gg, today for $6. And this is a sort of an affiliate stream. I do get affiliate credit for, them, you know, if you use my affiliate link. Just kind of showing off the game here. Hello, excuse you, you were very in the way. Did you know that? Do you know how in the way you are? This is not a good day to be in the way. Yes. He's rubbing the mic. I'm afraid this is as far as I can take you. I'm sorry. Anything close to the city is too dangerous. Surely that shouldn't be a problem for a priestess like you. Yeah, we have a sick, like, hoodie, so obviously we'll be safe. Fighting with a leaf must be difficult. I'm sure it's fine. But I have faith in your ability to seal the curse away. It's spread to your land, after all. For now, maybe the best you can do is seek an audience with our queen. Can we turn off the slow text? Parker, please don't hit the thing with your tail. Oh, I hate when games do that with the text by, like, the moment-by-moment text. And no way to, skip it. It's not a dialogue-heavy game anyway, I don't think. But yeah, it's a side-scrolling platformer. Lots of bosses. Half-Coordinated did a really good speedrun of this, last AGDQ, SGDQ, I think. It's not super long. I think it's about 5 hours. I still obviously won't be finishing it. This is my first playthrough, by the way, if that wasn't clear. Hopefully I won't die too horribly and often. I've played, you know, Bunny Must Die and stuff, so I should be kind of okay. And Windmaker, you can fight with the leaf. I guess you can, but it's not really... The Deku Leaf only really stuns things. It's not really... Ow. It's not really, you know, your primary arsenal. What issue do you have with Beam, anyway? I don't... Like, some people have had some connectivity issues and stuff, and I don't get that. What do I... Oh. Okay, rolling into the spikes is not optimal. Ah! Wait, didn't I pass that thing? Was that thing not a checkpoint? I don't know what things are. Oh, let's go back and get this thing. I don't even know what the buttons are, so obviously I've not done it before. There we go. Yeah, I played... In Momo 3, I was a little intimidated by there being, like, shops and stuff. I just kind of... In a Metroidvania game, I'm not sure I really want shops, honestly. I've got Bellflower. Wait, what is the... Bellflower. Affects a small amount of HP per use. Sourflower. Oh, it's a usable healy thing. Okay. So we have Mega Man spikes, apparently. I've never been a huge fan of Mega Man spikes. It depends on the game, but... Unless it's like a per room checkpoint. Like, I kind of like Bunny Must Die's interpretation of spikes. They're one-hit KOs at the very start, but you can parry them for one thing, which is very rare. Oh, we have an arrow button. Okay. That's better. Okay, so B is not a good button to press when you are near spikes. Good to know. This is reminding me the grass stuff. It's reminding me the both Kirby's Dream Land 3 and Yoshi's Island had little background elements you can kind of brush up against with your feet. It was a very cool thing to see way back when. All right, we have save points. Okay, let me. Oh, I forgot to frickin' tweet. Hold on. God damn it. Yeah, I was having major technical issues before the stream, so. All discombobulated here. Typing with Parker assisting is a little difficult. Why did you say that I'm streaming Kirby's Dream Land 3? God damn it. Oh, I need to change something in Restreamio, don't I? Ah, oh, Restreamio, you suck sometimes. The social alert feature in Restreamio is really bad and annoying, honestly. Hey, Capitalist! Alright, we're all good. We can play the video James again. Take that, Kappa. I think that was a Kappa anyway. So the star things are- wait, what's this? Oh. Why was that tutorial not on screen while I was fighting the enemy? Poisoned? How dare you poison me? How dare you not wear clothes, you little imp thing? That's indecent. I'm fighting indecency. I think that's the plot of this game. Oh. Little gooey block. Okay. Ah, we need the morph ball. Okay. What's this? Get out of here! You're indecent! Sorry, we have to beat people up for being indecent. Oh wait, OBS over here. Oh right, my Mediacom finally showed up. And they did not fix the issue, but the issue is being fixed. So what happened is, oh gosh. What happened is I'm dying. I'm dying, Squirtle. Oh, I died, Squirtle. So apparently something happened in some like switch box of all of the connection things, and basically instead of everyone having their own connection direct, I'm sharing a connection with four other people, and that's very bad. So that is why things have been happening, and they have a work order in to fix that. And tomorrow is the last day that they're like supposed to be able, like, it was called in on Tuesday and they have until Friday to fix it, so they should be fixing it. Is it really a point of no return if there's nothing in front of it, though? Oh, I just noticed this is the giant centipedes! Centipedes? In my reverie? It's more likely than you think. Why is everything so cute in this game? I don't like fighting cute things. But yeah, Mediacom found the issue, and I guess some other people have been complaining too, so yeah. Basically four lines shared among four people. Or one line shared among four people instead of four lines, like one line per person. I should probably be using this bow more, shouldn't I? Maybe I should have picked easy moto. I don't usually pick easy moto unless I'm just, you know, screwing around for fun, but ah. I sort of feel with like, when I'm recording a game and I'm doing like a quick look sort of thing, like, I don't know, sometimes I don't want to like you know, just show how bad I am at it. I just want to show off the game, and sometimes I feel an easy mode can be useful for that. Yeah, I was not expecting cable internet would have this many problems. Just run past it? I guess. I'm not really used to that being a thing that you can, like, do. I never really liked when games, like, you know, there's some, like, critical thing, like, you can just ignore enemies, but there's nothing, it, like, never is like, hey, you can run past enemies, that's a thing you can do. Like, because you have expectations, when you go into a game, you have expectations built up from all the other games you've played, of course. So, if you're going to defy those expectations, you kind of got to, oh, there was a jumpy block. Like, a heads up is nice there. Now we finally found the second save point. Ivory bug. Oh, is this... This is now Twilight Princess. We are collecting bugs. We're gonna go find little bug girl and give her all of our bugs. Put a shirt on. Freaking indecent. How much... does the ogre have a health bar? Oh, hello, spider friend. Igoo! Aw, that spider was pretty kawaii. One-chan spidered us. On beam began and it froze. So is the video stream freezing or- oh. Oh, okay. It just doesn't stay open, it reopens. That's weird. Ow. I'm feeling a bit better with this bow situation going on, so maybe I'll try this ogre one more time. Extremely peaceful music for extremely not peaceful situations. Ah, yes. Combat. Am I don't... Let me guess, it's immune to the bow, isn't it? Oh, right, it's one of those games. I'm not used to this being a thing. I'm also not used to my buttons. Okay. Not too hard at all. It just has a lot of HP. Alright. We got the Astral Charm! I don't know what that does. I'm gonna equip it. Ivory Bug, a tiny harmless insect. This creature feeds on the body of deceased lifeforms, removing their sickness. Oh, diseased lifeforms. I thought it said deceased lifeforms, and I'm like, I'm not sure removing their sickness is gonna help you all that much. Well, help them all that much. What's this? Passive slots, Astral Charm. Passive effect, some enemies will drop twice as much money. Ooh. Okay, so I guess we can't go into the giant spike pit, can we? Gotta go fast. Oh, we can charge our bow. Doesn't look any different, but I'll trust that it's different. It made a boopy sound, so obviously it's very powerful. That's how video games work. I KO'd that one in one hit, so yeah, I'm pretty sure it does double or something. Hey, Sun Gaming. Hey, Small Birds. I think I saw you in Yoshi's Island. The insect has a The insect has a shop if you don't hit it? Okay. We'll shop at One-chan Spiders, then. Oh. Rest in peace, shop. Why does the spider have a shop? You can't do that to me. Oh. Oh, sweet! You can knock those out of the air. Alright, no shop for me. Who needs... This is... We're playing hard mode. I'm the hardest of core gamers. Ah. Gas pits. Hello, friend. Put a shirt on! I have no business with you. Go away, you stupid girl. How rude! Do you have a second line of dialogue? No, you don't. Ugh. Whatever. Allergies are super awful today. Yeah, I'm allergic to all this poison mist. My doctor said I'm not supposed to ingest poison. The good news is you can't shop for stats. So it's just like optional dumb stuff then, or... I hate when games have, like, big missable things. I guess it's like, oh, ivory bug. I guess that's the Dark Souls-ness, isn't it? I'm not really a big fan of that. Dark Souls does that thing where you can kill all of the shopkeeps. Except that was not obviously a shopkeep, so that's kind of not... That's not something that I would introduce in my game, personally. Alright, we better... Uh-oh. Ah, for Pete's sake. Why is this elevator the slowest thing in the entire universe? Oh, come on. Think you'll be back as you die in a minute or so? I'm pretty sure I saved, unless it... Does it respawn when you... Does it respawn when you hit a checkpoint even if you save after killing it? If it does, that's still kind of a weird way to do things. Ah, no! Come on. Okay, I'm like way back, I think. Wait, do I have the Charmidarm? Yes, I do. Okay. Ah, come on! Get out of here. Spider. Yeah, spider is dead. Rip. I'm just gonna heal. Yeah, I'm not really a huge... haven't, like, played any of them all the way through. But I am on the lesser side of the, you know... Giga frickin' Dark Souls fans thing. So I don't really appreciate a lot of weird design stuff they do. Honestly. And everyone kind of misinterprets, yeah, we don't need to talk to you. A lot of lessons from Dark Souls, so I prefer to just not talk about the series at all. And the thing with killing NPCs in Dark Souls, I'm pretty sure it was always like, you know, it's just kind of a thing you can do. I don't think it was ever like, oh, I accidentally killed the only item giver for the next, like, 2 hours. Oops. Because he looked exactly like an enemy. Oh, for Pete's sake. Oh, for Pete's sake. Double Pete's sake. Okay, I'm just gonna turn it on easy. I'm not... Tonight is not a good night for restarting every 2 seconds. Not after OBS decided to completely fuck up for, like, the 10,000th time. Aw, no, not unskippable cutscenes! You can't do this to me! Oh my gosh. Yeah, I don't care, Mr. Blind Man. Can I kill Mr. Blind Man? Aw, the one guy I wanted to kill! How dare you. I don't know, he's got face bandages. It's usually a sign that somebody's blind. Go left. You can't just go left in a side-scroller. Is the morph ball to the left? Oh. Okay. Do I make this go somehow? Boat. How do I boat? We have Mega Man. Oh. Oh! What? You jumped- What? That doesn't even make sense. Okay, you jump to not swim. I can't- my code of ethics will not allow me to call that swimming. But you press jump to do whatever that is. Okay. Alright, I keep forgetting we have these bell flowers. I do not like using consumable items, but I- wait, how do I even use that? Passive. Oh, for Pete's sake, I'll figure it out at the next save thing. Oh, Bellflowers are restored at save points? Oh, okay. That's neat. Oh yeah, that is pretty Dark Souls-y. Okay, yeah, how do I... Oh, it's Y. Okay. Oh, for... Meant to do that. Oh, for Pete's sake! Why does the thing block you? It's a night of learning, my friends. This time's lesson is that little ball blocks you for some reason. This is not a game for impatient people. I can see the value in sort of the Dark Souls design philosophy, but I gotta say, generally, I prefer the Bunny Must Die sort of things. Bunny Must Die tends to make it very clear how you screwed up, and usually get some chance. Like, I guess there's spikes early on, but I don't know. Like, Bunny Must Die would not slow you down like that. And it definitely would make that stupid thing block you. I don't know, it's a very old school sort of teaching thing. I just really like Bunny Must Die, and Dark Souls just feels very different in how it does its difficulty, and I am not really a huge fan of how it does that. Oh, thanks for the follow, Pandiego. Biomorph Ball Cave. We'll presumably see you later. Ah! Put some clothes on. Pete's sake. Does my jumpy attack do more damage than the leaf? Like, the standing leaf? Because sometimes I defeat him in one hit. I think it must be that. Alright, Mr. Ogre, I'm tired of your crap. I do like his little face, though. It's all, like, creepy-like. Ah, that's the jump button. Dang, you really get a lot of health for easy mode, don't you? It doesn't matter at all because of spikes. There we go. They're wearing, like, panties, but... There's definitely some nudism going on. Yeah, the ogre is naked, but that's why I had to kill it. I am on a mission to purify this land of the sinful. Except for the sinful that are out of reach. That's just impractical. Oh. I keep forgetting it's a bellflower. Boop. You're probably not supposed to just climb up in there, but it does work, so whatever. I need to remember I have this bellflower. That's important. Well, if you're watching this naked, I'm afraid I will have to kill you. It's just how this works. So they're wearing gray shirts. I see no difference in body and leg and face color. Also, where did these little imp things get frickin' poison grenades? Like... I don't know. Back to the centipede room. Skin color is gray. It all looks the same color to me. I mean, gray, green, sure, but all of the relevant bits are the same color, whether it's green or gray. Oh, poisoned. Oh, we didn't. We missed Spider One-chan. Hold on, we have to go back. Also, you're a jerk. You gotta be kidding me. I can kill the NPC that I don't want to kill, but none of the ones that I do. Okay. Okay, let's go find Spider One-chan. She has Kawaii Ugu's for us. I do like that you can cancel those. Hi, Mr. Spider. Ugu! Excuse- Did you lie to me? This isn't a shop. This is just death. Why would you lie to me? I hate that spider now. Ow. Are there other spiders that actually are shopkeepers? Either way, it's weird that it didn't respawn. I have no idea what's going on then. Get out of here, radish man. Ow. There we go. Oh, right. Leaf thing. Okay. I must be like some sort of Canadian superhero. Because when I jump, like, maple leaves come out. The spider remembers you killed it. Is the spider sans? Oh yeah, the New Vegas. I do not appreciate New Vegas's reputation system in some ways. Oh, hello, centipede lady. Arthropod demon Edna. Not quite Etna. Man, check out them legs, girl! All like 20 of them. Hmm. I don't like how hard mode or normal mode is like you die every 2 seconds, and easy mode is like my health bar is 10 miles long. Like, this should be like mega giga easy mode and have like a just sort of easy mode that is just a little bit less crazy. Yes, if that was a real question, Sorten, yeah, there's a reputation system in New Vegas. And it completely screwed me over because I don't remember ever attacking a Securitron, but Mr. House. I was going for Mr. House's, like, thing. And, aww. No one gives you the same amount of health as you have once you have a... Once you use bellflowers, but bellflowers don't... Bellflowers just restore, don't they? I don't know what they do. Cough. Aw, crap, it's Sans. I'm sorry, who are you? I see, you're a silent protagonist. What a unique name. I can't do the... Oh, he stopped doing the shaky voice anyway. Call me Ascorn. I take it you are unaware of the situation of these lands. Yes, I'm aware of the nudity situation. You mentioned in your journey that you brought here in search of the Queen. If you really intend to continue further in the kingdom of Karfst, beware. A ghastly presence has been enveloping everything. Are you just playing as a moral guardian? Yes, we are Maple Leaf Girl. We have come from Canada, and we are going to purge the land of the nudists. Sacred Grove is one of the few untouched spots. It seems pretty touched to me. There's, like, horrible monsters everywhere. Carved City. Oh. Moon's nice and red tonight. That's a good sign. I like that background. The leaf makes more sense now. Yes. We're not killing anyone. We're just placing leaves over the genitals. Are you a bad burb? Aw. I wanted to pet the burb. What did you do to the burb, Mrs. Skeleton Lady? You came from that imp-infested forest? Ha 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 ha. Interesting. How can I help you? See, this is what shopkeeps look like. Not spiders, bad pee. I don't know what these are. Oh, thank you. Temporarily increases attack by 50%. Oh, I don't like consumable things. Oh, passive effect, yes. Status ailments? Ring of Candor. Emits a sound when near secrecy. Aw, oh, hell yeah. Let's just get a fairy tier for now. Oh wait, does the active thing come back? I just want that Ring of Candor. Oh, I can't hurt the burb. Okay, you can't hurt The shopkeeps. BP just lied to me. Oh well. Hey! She's just like spooky. Like one of those like old ladies you see in like period pieces. Hey, I thought I killed you. There you go. Hi, blood dog. How you doing, my friend? Do you need a leaf embedded strictly up your asshole? I think you do. There you go, my friend. Enjoy. Ah, bloody ladder, my favorite. Mysteriously blocked doorway. Karst crest needed to pass. Burb. Oh, we can't hurt the burbs. So dogs are bad, burbs are good? Is that what this game is trying to say to me? That's biased, but I agree. Maybe you can't hit that particular shopkeep. The barrel attacked me! The barrel attacked me! I'm offended. You find a vitality fragment. Your HP is already maxed. Oh, okay. So it just sets our HP to max from the start. Alright, maybe I didn't need to put it on easy mode, but like I said, this is not good. This is not a good night. Not after that OBS bullcrap, which is still not really resolved. I don't want to deal with difficulty right now. I just want to hit things with leaves. It's the one thing that brings me joy. Hitting people with leaves. Hey! Get out of here, frickin' Deku scrub! Nervous, some people. Oh, hi. I thought maybe she was nice because she didn't attack, but no. Bellflower. Ah, you- I was reading that! Get out of here! I was reading things. You can't attack a lady while she's reading things. See, look at this lady. Make this stop. Okay. I'll make it stop. Hey! I'm here to make you stop. Dickbag. Well, I definitely killed the hell out of that spider, but I don't know if the spider was important or not. I've been misled. Oh, you can charge while moving. Okay, that's nice. Oh, it wasn't always all the way charged. I see, okay. I like that when you can charge while moving, you know, that Mega Man sort of thing. Aw, don't make constant noises at me. Oh, thank you, it did- After I complained, it stopped making the noise. I like that. It's a conscientious game. Oh, spooky boss time? Hi, spooky boss. Huh? She's so scared of the spooky boss, look at her. Huh? Looks like some outsider missionary. Kee-hee-hee. Ha-ha-ha. Your rotten corpse will serve my mistress well. The most intimidating boss I've ever seen. Look at this. I'm so scared of this boss. I'm gonna shoot your bullets. Oh! It's like bullet hell, might. I'm just gonna pellet you with bullets. What's that? Oh. I like when you can erase bullets. I didn't quite do it right, but still. Ow. Toho reference? I mean, it's pretty... just any bullet hell. Oh, rest in peace, mate! Oh, hello. This is the titty giantess that everyone, like, every screenshot of this game has her. I can't imagine why. What's this? Oh! Pfft. Okay. It's the poopy lady. I'm so glad that jiggle physics were added here. It's very important. See, even she likes it! Ow. I need to remember there's a roll button. See, I remember there's a roll button, and see how well things worked. I keep expecting her to, like, smash me with her tits when she does that move. Like, I expect her to, like, impact me against the ground, but instead she just leaves. What a gameplay mechanic that would be. Pro tip, hit boobies until the Kako Demon dies. That was the Cyber Demon, though. You don't shoot the Cyber Demon until the Kako Demon dies. You shoot the Cyber Kako Demon until the Kako Demon dies. Or, fuck, made me screwed up. Oh, and I love her mouth, by the way. You little pest. I can't do voices today. I'm not in the mood for voices. I can't waste any more time with you. Anja, her antlers are good, too. Bye. Sorry about making you kill your little mite friend. Oh my god, I looked at the chat and... Why does water do that? Well... Guess we get to fight Titty Lady again. It's not open from the side, of course. Sigh. I guess the save points aren't really that far away, but at the same time, I feel like we lose a lot to some really stupid stuff. Like, why... Why does water do that? And why are these just tantalizingly out of reach? Can't do that to me. Wait, do we go down? I don't think we'd go down here, but I think that's just the room we enter anyway. Get out of here. Get out of my face! This is my face area. You need to be out of it. I'm not falling for you twice, Deku Scrub. That Deku Scrub was a real Deku Scrub. Do not taunt, Happy Fun Lake. Can I charge my... No, I can't charge the normal attack. Are those spikes? I think those are spikes. That's rude. Spikes should be more obvious than that. I'm so glad that it only blips like two more times. What is this? Smeekrits? Oh no, this is just... Oh, I didn't open the door! Oh, whatever. I think this is a one-way anyway. Yeah, yeah, you're a little bug. Oh hey, it doesn't repeat! I like when games do that. They don't, repeat cutscenes for stuff like that if you ow. If you die and have to redo them. Oh, it'll be open anyway. Alright. Can I do any sick moves with up and down? Not really. Poor little mite thingy. He just unceremoniously dies in the lake. I love how just this entire fight is you just slap titties for about 5 minutes. And then she just leaves. Just like, yeah. Bot Vice. I've heard of that, but I can't, like, remember exactly what it is. So I have no meaningful input. You little pest. Blah, blah, blah. Nice, I like her, like, decay away effect. Which makes sense. She's like Witch of Decay, right? Stupid burbs. Of course, the bell was here. Oh, you can just smack the bell around. I'm so glad that you can save it without opening the little menu. That's really a neat touch. I'm always for like any little thing, any little time save that saves me from going into stupid menus. And stuff. Basically the opposite of Animal Crossing menus. I see you, Pit! I see you. These burbs. Oh, sorry, I thought you were an enemy. What are you looking at? I'm a human, like you. You don't seem very capable of protecting yourself. Did you see how many freaking doggos and burbs I just fought off? I just fought a titty monster, okay? Take my word and look for shelter. My name is Kath. I'm a Nidus in service of the kingdom. You can destroy checkpoints in Shovel Knight? So, you're a priestess from Lun, and you're looking for the Queen's Aid? Also, I have no idea if these games are, like, connected. I think they are somewhat, but I haven't played the earlier games. I mean to, but, like I said, I'm playing this one because it's on sale on chrono.gg for today. So, you can get a good deal on it over there. It's only $6.50, and, seems really cool, despite my complaining. I'm mostly complaining just because I spent, like, 10 minutes screwing with frickin' OBS after doing all of my stuff with Mediacom, you know, supposed to be fixing my internet, so. It is not a good day over in Tapland, but whatever. You think she has an interest in your little village? Well, here's some bad news. I've heard rumors of an undead witch lurking around. Doesn't ring a bell. Progressing deeper into the city is very risky. If you're adamant about meeting with the queen, my advice only goes so far. Whatever. Stupid water. Oh! Get out of here, Charon. Oh! And your money goes into the water. Of course it does. Freaking jerk. Got magnet stone. Hey, I was reading that. This freaking guy is attacking me while I'm reading things. Oh no, that's Charon. Excuse me. There's a No Man's Sky. Oh yeah, I'd heard there was already a No Man's Sky clone. I don't know what it's called, but. Oh, wait, what? Is this death or no? What? Okay. I don't think this is how buoyancy works, but whatever. Good news, now you can get all of your muns. Oh, I don't think I'm gonna bother grinding. Planet Nomads? It even kind of has a ring of it, like No Man's Sky. Oh, hello. That is a total Dark Souls knight, dude. Yeah, as much as I hate to say it, I do kind of see why all of the Dark Souls comparisons happen. I guess the slowest elevator ever, thank you. What's this? Notices your orb. What's this? Well, you tried to speedrun this game like you did Bunny. Oh, wow, those really are worth a lot of money. I guess they're, like, rich priss demon things. But nah, I probably won't speedrun this like Bunny. Unless I ended up, like, I run Bunny because I really love Bunny. But I don't know. I mean, I don't dislike this. Oh, right. Orb. Hit the orb. It's unlike. Oh, get out of here, Chomp Rock. The Dark Souls of Knights, yes. What's that? Oh, you got different magic now? Oh, how good for you! I'm still gonna kill you, though. Yeah, those things are worth a lot of muns. What's this? I think I need to bring a small gray juice box to this gate. You're right, it was a much faster elevator. I guess I'll take that over the other one. That was a it was a fire doggo all along. I did not even see that. Locked. The No Man's Sky icon is called Dawn of Andromeda. Oh, hello, friend. The Royal Court has been ignoring its citizens ever since the kingdom fell to a curse. How are you alive? How did you live? I demand an explanation for this. If you want to stay safe, don't leave outside. They were inside too. I don't think that helps. Don't come any closer. Okay. Oh well. You seem sane enough. Joke's on you, loser. You're a priestess seeking an audience with the royal court. In the present state, reaching the castle is highly difficult. You won't find help easily in the city, but my master might be able to guide you. She lives inside the city's monastery, surrounded by cats. Oh, I like her already. Have you seen the people of the city? Everybody is lost. Fear destroys our minds. Stay safe. I'm pretty sure fear is reasonable when, like, absolutely everything is trying to kill you. Except for the burbs. Oh. Suddenly there's, like, a lot of non-dead people. Why did you jump in the way of the NPC? A neophyte? Do you seek salvation? I love her, like, confused dog head tilts. That's her only form of communication. She just tilts her head and gives puppy dog eyes, and everybody's just like, yeah, I'll just continue this conversation for you, it's fine. You can achieve salvation from eternal damnation by donating to St. Ellison. Our recommendation is at least 15 months. Oh my gosh! It actually is months. Here, have your 15 months. May you find peace. She jumps in front of them. Like, she doesn't want the character, the player, to see the other NPCs. She just, like, dashingly jumps in front of them so they could look at her instead. We're a small minority now that Her Highness propagated her destruction. Most of the population has lost faith in the gods. She's to blame for all that's wrong now. Okay. Sure, a lot of you here. St. Ellison is absolute. Her wish reigns supreme. You are safe here with us. Oh. Dot, dot, dot. I like how I jumped a little extra far that time, like, boop, and then I boop again. What's this? It's just cosmetic, I guess. What's this? Personnel only? Pfft. I don't listen to what signs tell me. Oh. Maybe I should have listened to what signs told me. Oh, what's this? Oh. Spooky medieval elevator, okay. These are oddly common. I was gonna say words, but I forgot them. Ah, it's you! What the? Ow. Get out of here. But yeah, I will probably try to play a few more bunny runs. Runs of Bunny Must Die. But I just ended up so busy. Oh, that was an explosive barrel. Yeah, speedrunning just takes... Oh, I knew it was an explosive barrel that time, but just... Oh, you! It's an explosive Deku scrub. Everything explodes in this room. I don't like this room. I don't like your face. Oh, I like your face even less. I guess you're an enemy. He's just standing. He doesn't even... Got tainted missive. Is that really all you got? I guess he's got that and a crap ton of health. Get all the muns. Oh no, not in the pit! It burns! Map? Oh, extremely Metroid-y map. Well, I guess Castlevania too, but anyway. Maple Leaf, Ivory Bug. Tainted Missive. Temporarily increase your attack, but monitor the cost of HP. Okay, how do I do the different thing though? Huh? I don't... Oh. There's a staircase right there, but we won't use it because we have a jumpy puzzle to use instead. Oh, monies! Just put your money in a bell. Why not? It's like Animal Crossing. Do check my equipment. Oh, have I missed stuff? Oh, I have Adorned Ring passive. Oh, that's why the game is easy. Okay. Slowly restores HP. Okay, so easy mode just kind of ups your health and gives you a couple things. Middle Western Empire, evident by its engraving. Increases invincibility frames, that's nice. Ooh, attracts money stars. Heck yes. Sometimes drop. Okay, I'm gonna get all of the items, the money things, since this seems easy enough already. So I'm just gonna get the most muns. Animal Crossing? Yeah, there's Animal Crossing speedruns. Oh yeah, that's what I was talking about. Bunny Must Die. So I'll probably get back to Bunny Must Die at some point, but just with the spooky streams and then the Yoshi streams. Like, oh, that's a pit. That's like a Donkey Kong Country move right there. See those teeny tiny spikes there? That's rude. But yeah. I'll probably play it a bit more, but because it did come out on PS4. And it's a bit easier to play now for me. And but just I have fairly few nights where I can stream reasonably. And ooh, even if the money falls into the pit, you still get it. That's nice. But it's just, oh, we already went, we're here. Did I not go right? Oh, you learned even more new tricks. Oh, it's another door. I don't like doors. But yeah, there's Animal Crossing speedruns. There's an all debts, which is kind of the, you know, beat the game, I suppose. Or 100% collection, which takes like over a full day, I believe, of like real time. But somebody did it. It's mostly, you know, a joke category. But it's still kind of interesting in its own way. All debts is pretty boring. Oh, right. How do I... There we go. I like how she doesn't, like, eat the bell flower or anything. She just does a cool fist pump. And she's healthy again. She wasn't even on screen. How dare you not even be on screen and attack me? Uh-oh. Don't you drop books at me. Just because books are my greatest weakness. Wow. Free muns. Can I just... That is, like, almost unfair. Just free muns for running through this pit. Thank you, pit. Unfortunately, there isn't... Oh, I was just about to say, there hasn't been a store for a while. She doesn't have the thing I wanted to buy! This is the greatest injustice I have ever experienced. I can't believe this. Whatever. But, I wanted to buy the thing that gives you, makes sounds when you get secrets. Ow. I'm trying to read chat. What controller am I using? I'm using the Xbox One Elite controller. I was gonna use my PS4 controller because I prefer its D-pad. But, it wasn't already connected, so I just went with this. I have enough spare PS4 controllers now, I can probably just... connect it, already. Or have a wired connection. You don't remember the sound near secrecy thing being remotely useful? It's just the sort of thing I like to have, because I like my secrets. But I don't like... I like getting all of the secrets, but I don't like, you know... Use the x-ray visor on every literal pixel in the entire game. Sort of secret finding. Question marks? She doesn't even say that it's locked anymore. She's just confused by the very presence of a door. The new style of PS4 controller? It's not just on the PS4 Pro. The PS4 Slim has it too. Oh, this is the cat lady! You're good peoples. I can already tell. She has a witch hat. She has books, and she has lots of cats. I mean, you can't go wrong. But, clearly Mars is easier to make money on Earth. I haven't played Adventure Capitalist. Is that an idle game, or, like, what is that? I know a few people playing that. But I kind of have a billion games to play anyway, which is why I never ended up playing these Momo games until now. A devout from Lun, I see. You can call me Kulitard. Cotillard. Okay. Your name loses some points, but you're still pretty cool. She's got one of those, like, sweep-over things where you can't see one of her eyes, so that compensates for it. Oh, you've met with Paramol? Sure. Kikiki, such innocence. So, you're concerned with your homeland. Indeed, the darkness assaulting your people hails from here. Our queen has become possessed by a malevolent greed. She's the one responsible for many casualties, not only here, but in other lands, too. Kikiki. Uh-oh. Boss fight. Perhaps you should head to the castle. Just don't expect kindness from those who live there. You'll have to find the way on your own. Here. This will let you out a bit. Oh, she just, you know. The blood, like, shotness of her eye just went away. She drained the blood out of, like, her pocket or something. Got monastery key. Be careful. It's only been a year since all this started, but most of our population is completely degenerated. So is, like, the virus something that, like, turns people into those thingies, or do they just, like, frickin' die? I really like that swoosh effect. I love anything with blur frames. Too few games have good blur frames. Parky? That's my water. You can't have it. Is this what that question mark door was? Nope. Wait. Oh, I thought maybe you could blow the door away. Apparently not. Not a lot of verticality going on, but, I guess human architecture isn't very vertical anyway. Give me the muns. Give me all of the muns that I probably won't be able to use. I think I actually stopped playing Momo 3 because it did something similar where, like, the very first chop has something that costs, like, $18 billion. And, I mean, it wasn't, like, completely impossible to grind to get, but I wanted it, and I wasn't sure if I would get it again. Hey, you gamer. Wait, have I gone down? I have not. That's right, Parker. Speaking of verticality... Hello. Oh, I thought this was gonna be like the SM64 Endless Staircase. Cinder Chambers. Oh, hello. It's like a spooky Bernie ghost. Hi, Bernie ghost friend. She's a babushka! What? I don't know what that was about. I want to go get that treasure chest. Hold on. Oh no. That's way better. Okay, what the? Who's calling me? Ah, oh, fucking hell. Almost every call I get is like freaking spam. And I had to turn off my spam, like, I use Mr. Number, an Android app, to block spam calls and crap. Wait, wasn't there another thing? It was an offshoot, wasn't there? To block spam calls and stuff, but I had to turn it off because Mediacom, they use freaking restricted numbers for some reason. I guess so people don't call them back and stuff. But it's so annoying, because, like, only spam accounts tend to use those numbers. Oh, of course it's locked. Blurg. Hi, babushka lady. Burning babushka. It's a burn bushka. How dare you take more than one combo? Yeah, I don't usually answer restricted numbers either, but I've learned that the restricted number is Mediacom calling me about, you know, my intro tubes. Uh-oh, jumpy puzzles. Not really puzzles, but ow! I just roll directly into that, sure. That's what I meant to do. This is not where I expected to go. Oh! You got a little bit of a... Oh, it's fine, never mind. Oh, god damn it! Who the fuck? I think it was Mediacom with it. Yeah, it was Mediacom that called me again. Why do they use restricted numbers? It's so annoying. Okay, this one is a store. Wanna buy? Drill arrows? Hell yeah! Ring of Candor. Oh, hey, it's only 200 bucks now. So this is One-chan Spider's store. You're forgiven, BP. If you press up or down on the message entry space, you can see your previous messages. Huh. But they probably do it so people don't, like, call back their service people, like, to pester them and stuff, I guess. But I don't know. I mean, restricted messages are almost always spam, so... Passive effect, expected sound, yes. And now I need, wait, what does the impurity thing even do? Wanna buy? Passive effect, restores HP when every user is poisoned? I always liked when you get, like, you know how some enemies, like, heal from lava and stuff? I loved how, in certain Final Fantasy games and other stuff, you'll get, like, enemy effects like that, where poison will heal you and stuff. Boss fight time, I assume. That's one of the bosses where you have to fight in water. Oh, it's a spooky mimic! Oh, that wasn't really a boss, was it? Uh-oh. I didn't think this would be a one-way. Arg. Oh, it's a mummy! I love that she has lower health because she was already in a fight. That's cute. I'm so glad I can't, like, friendly fire her. After that spider, I was so worried this was going to be, like, one of those games you can, like, accidentally murder your best friend and the game's just like, hey, you murdered your best friend, you freaking jerk. And I'm like, I just pressed the B button! I didn't even know they were there! Oh, right, bell thing. How do I... Okay. Oh dang, she hurts a lot. Fucking hell, stop calling. Okay, phone. Welcome to Mute Town. No, no, fuck off. Let me mute you. Focus on avoidance while Buddy kills her? Ugh, but that's cheap. But probably a good idea. Oh, hello. I wasn't sure if this was one of those fights where, like, the Buddy dies if you suck too hard. I hate when games that do that too, but yeah. Our Buddy seems to be doing way more damage to her than I can. I keep forgetting about this bow, though. Why does everyone else have way cooler powers than I do? I use a freaking leaf. You know, she has, like, volcano geysers, and, you know, I have maple leaf. This is what I get for being a Canadian superhero. Okay, I'm just gonna let Buddy Friend do this instead. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. No, what are you doing? There we go. I think they're calling for, like, how did
our services help you, and blah blah blah. We're giving you a survey immediately after, and blah blah blah.
Whatever. Thank you for your assistance. Are you hurt? It's my first time seeing a sacred leaf in action. Not exactly impressive, but whatever. See ya, Sorten. Certainly an interesting way of fending off enemies. She just gave me one of those, what do you call that? Underhanded compliment, yeah. Since you're still around, perhaps you'll hear me out. Well, I want to pick no, but I'll say yes. Good. Is it just me or the audio just go bizwhack? I don't know. I'm playing with my stupid... Oh! Wait, what? Oh. Never mind. Everything looks fine. Queen and I once served as a noble and caring. She's turned into a morbid figure. Anything under direct control is lost, so I've deserted her order of knights. You totally see Kermit as a customer support guy. Here's my proposal, taking down the queen. Just a little bit of regicide. It's casual regicide, nothing fancy, nothing fancy. Is it still regicide if it's a queen, or is it like a different thing? You mentioned her curse has reached your homeland. choose to side with me. You're gonna need a special crest. Aw, hell yeah! It's like a secret handshake! We're a club. Aw. People always breaking things into different pieces, and then somehow they work when you... I mean, have you ever actually... Have like, video game developers ever actually broken something into four pieces? Because most things do not go back into one piece and actually work. Just saying. You break your keyboard into four pieces, it's not going to be a keyboard when you put them back together. One of its fragments should be around here. Once you have the four parts, head to the locked door at the entrance of the city. Okie dokie. I only regicide at parties. Oh. Ah! How dare you. Whatever. Leaf. No remote saving for me. You found a crest fragment. Its essence grants you the ability to dodge in midair. Heck yes, I was trying to do that earlier. Wait. What? Oh, that signifies your ability to dodge again. Okay. Oh. Well, now I know why. What? The statue hurts? Why does the statue hurt? How was I supposed to know the statue hurts? Okay, we have murder statues now, apparently. The frickin' statues hurt. That's great. Can I murder the statue? I sure can. The statue was like, hey, knock that off, and then I killed it. What got fixed? Oh my god, Kermit's back. Play-Doh can be broken in four pieces and fit back together perfectly. Check me. Ow. I keep reading the chat and getting hit. Ow! Oh, your computer audio's freaking out. It's probably like damaged cable or something, or like a cable bumping up against something naughty. So I think this is the way back up, so let's look this way. Because there might be secrets. There's a smecret. I see the smecret. Oh, spikes. Those are a bad smecret. Aw, it doesn't fully heal you! How rude! Aw, it's just this little dude! Ah! Get out of here, little dude. I'll take this item, though. We got Cinder Key. Oh. It's probably, like, the thing that lets us leave. Oh, the spikes. I forgot the spikes. Okay, spike! For Pete's sake. So those spikes are not an instant kill, but then I walked into them twice. Thank you for your time, valuable caller. Of course, you should have known the statue hurts you. You read our readme.txt file that was in the installation DVD. Ow. Get out, get out. Like how it like notices it's being shot and it's like, hey, wait a minute. And then it dies. Where are those arrows coming from? Ow. Alright. Let's try not to go to the spikes this time. Final Fantasy 15. Oh yeah, I was gonna start streaming World of Final Fantasy at some point here. Though I guess they messed up the first patch. They somehow it's a bug specific to the game, but they messed up the patch. So the first patch does weird stuff on PS4 Pro only, and only for that game, and only for that patch. Oh my god, I hate spikes so much. What? I hate the Mega Man spike thing. I don't mind like normal game design spikes, I'm okay with. Like, I really liked how Bunny Must Die does spikes. Let's just hit the bell so I don't have to do that again. But yeah, in Bunny Must Die, you can parry the spikes. It's a really neat touch. You fell on spikes and died. So where can I find this game? Oh, it's on sale on chrono.gg. You can just go here. Link in the chat. Ow, ow, ow. No! Uh-oh, chat relay, don't do a loop. Don't do the thing again. I think they fixed that bug. Hold on, let me double check my stream. Yep, I'm not dropping frames this stream. Hopefully they should fix it, and my last stream should be the last one with- Oh my god. Oh yeah, I've seen some people posting, some dumb glitches of, like, trucks hitting people and screwing with trucks in, Final Fantasy XV. Now, the chat thing used to, have a bug where it would repeat each other, or, like, it would relay the chat in another thing, and, like, it would say, you know, Bob said hi in Twitch, and then so the chat says hi in YouTube, and then it reads its own message and repeated it back to Twitch. You can hit the backs of those. I thought those were... Oh, for Pete's sake. Anyway. Let's use that healy-dealy thing. Oh, fuck! I did not mean to do that. Okay, the B button is very dangerous. I'm not... It's one of those things where it has, like, complex controls. I'm just not really used to them. Well, not even, like, complex, but, like... You know, there's skill involved. I guess that's close enough to being complex. Yeah, Bunny Must Die. I look really great in Bunny Must Die, but, you know... Your first time playing Bunny Must Die, you're gonna die a lot. It's almost like it's the name of the game or something, I don't know. Give me the thing. Yes. Why? What? I'm so confused. I thought I would be able to hurt that one since I could hurt the one before. Is it like only that one spider that is like you're not supposed to hurt? That's almost like Zodiac Spear level bullcrap. I'm sorry.
You know, Tap-Tap, if you just, you know, don't step on the 31st spider that, you know, tries to inject poison, you know, into your urethra, it will eventually trade you the magic monocrystal 18 hours later.
How can I help you? Ooh, red ring! That's a small health, but enemies won't order money. Yeah, I don't have 500 monies. Ow. Is there a top to this? No, there's not, so let's go. Need to touch with the erratic bloodstains under the spikes, though. Because a lot of things will just be everything, every, like, spike tile will be identical. But in this game, it does a little more... You know, spikes should be erratic. That's the thing I always liked about the Tap-Tap's design in Yoshi's Island. Was the spikes are, like, unevenly set, and it's a really nice touch. Which, by the way, if you ever do Tap-Tap fan art, do be aware that the spikes are wide set and unevenly so. And... How the heck? How do I get up? Do I get up? Yeah, the Zodiac Spear was some bullcrap. Wait, oh, I guess I go back here. I never got a Final Fantasy guide after Final Fantasy IX, because that was some... That guide, I complained about that in another stream. But that guide was the worst. It just tells you to go to this website. Use the cinder key. Okay. Oh, right. Statue. They're Chozo statues! It's burbs! There's a lot of burbs in my life lately. Oh, she's got the comet shot from Legend of Dark Witch. Oh, I did the thing again. I kind of hate this roll button sometimes. I'm not used to it. That's the real problem. I'm just not used to it, but... I never even went to that website. I think there was like a login or something. I don't know. I just never used the website. And I just held a grudge against their guides from that point on. I like how the spider is like terrified. It's like, it knows it's selling contraband. It knows it's not allowed to sell to humans. It's only supposed to sell to spiders, but he's breaking the rules just for you. Just for you, my friend. Today only. You gotta buy now. Yeah, play online, that's what it was. Yeah, I never used it. I think that was like... I have to show you this now. The Final Fantasy X PS2 title screen looks like some, like, GeoCities nightmare. Wait, no, that's the Final Fantasy X. That's the remaster. Now, show me the bad one. Oh, yeah, that's the one. Oh, beautiful. You have to see this monstrosity. If you've never played Final Fantasy X on PlayStation 2, this is seriously what you see when you turn on Final Fantasy X. Final Fantasy X official website, www.playonline.com, and the little GeoCities logo, and this shitty water gradient thing. Like, it looks like something from GeoCities. It's so awful. And so it was a great game, obviously, but what a terrible first impression. Wow. It's kind of hard to believe, but like every single website in the entire universe looked exactly that bad for a long time. And it just kind of seemed like that's how things were. It didn't seem weird at the time, but oh my god, it's so bad. Yeah, that's every time you turned on the game, that is what you saw. After like a pretty good intro, like a fancy CGI intro, if I recall correctly. But yeah, Final Fantasy always had such good minimalist title screens that would show the Amano art they would have, or maybe they would show something dramatic like Cloud's Buster Sword. You know, they'd be fancy, and you can't air dash through those things, apparently. They'd be nice. They'd either be fancy or they'd be, like, minimalist. They'd be tasteful overall. I keep forgetting my bell flowers. But yeah, it was just real embarrassing. Oh, hi friend. Oh, speaking of Legend of Dark Witch, it's coming to PC very soon. It passed green lights and it's getting close to done. I'll hopefully have a video for it whenever it comes out. Speaking of old websites. Oh wait, I missed, what did that do? I was reading chat. Oh yeah, it looks much nicer on PS4, or the PS3, etc. version. You know, the remaster, it looks fine. It's not actually that different, it's just, like, the parts that don't suck. They upgraded the stupid water texture. I'll just show it to you since I already showed you the other one, right? The water thing is still kind of dumb. And the HD remaster bit is a little... This is still not my favorite screen, but it's acceptable. What am I doing here? I guess I'm going up. Now we get to go on the bouncy jiggle puzzle. Wait, did I even go this way? Oh no, I didn't go left. Monastery key, crest tribe. Let's read some flavor text. It used to lock the doors of the Cinder Chamber as an annex of Essen Covenant. The chamber is once a storage for censors. Were partially burned and locked up to prevent further casualties. Fraction of an emblem representing the current Karstain regime. Four parts are needed to access the areas leading to the castle's gates. Opens the door of the Upper Elson Covenant. The Covenant and its annexes have been abandoned once they fell to the Queen's uncontrollable dark sorcery. I've only found one ivory bug. I bet you can't get, like, the secret ending where a dog was controlling everything all along if you don't get all of the ivory bugs. Oh, hello, giant moth creature. Well, I guess you're not that giant. I mean, for a moth, yes, but we saw a bigger moth creature before. Well, I guess she was more of a centipede. Well, let's call her a caterpillar. Halfway. Meet halfway. Sure are a lot of skulls around here. Where do these people... Hey! Get out of here. Where do these people lose all the rest of their bones? You always see the skulls, but fairly rarely do you see the other bits. You know, equal bone representation, that's all I'm asking for. Whiteleaf Memorial Park! With spikes, you know, you gotta have some spikes to memorialize the people that we lost to the spikes in the last memorial park that we built. Ah yes, these are the gravestones of all of the people that fell on the spikes that we put in the park for some reason. The city council doesn't think it was the best idea, but... Oh. You're cute, but we have to kill you. Wait, can I shoot the stem? Okay, that's much easier. Better than MK where everyone has multiple skulls and rib cages. Yeah, true. Now, I feel bad for defeating that, because it wasn't even in the way. It was just kind of... Well, it was in the way, but I mean... It was not a threat. Oh, you're still alive. Excuse me. Oh, no! Now, I no longer feel bad. Oh. Oh, we didn't have to kill it, but it's fine, because it respawns instantly. It's kind of hard to feel bad for it, then. What console gen is this? This is the 8th gen. If you mean, like, PlayStation 4 and stuff, this is, you know, PC game. But I assume you mean, like, what gen are people playing on? Oh my gosh! Saved by the double jump. It's one feature this has that Bunny Must Die doesn't have. But Bunny Must Die is, you know, it's supposed to be, it's a very deliberate movement game. So a double jump could be seen as not something you want in a game like that. The double jump in Bunny Must Die is doing a parry off of certain enemies, which is actually necessary to do certain really cool tricks, like the sequence break. Wait, I guess I can't go that way. I guess this is a little peek of something we'll go visit later. Technically, 7th gen didn't get a trilogy, main trilogy of FF games. I mean, it had 3 Final Fantasy 13s. Does that count? I guess Final Fantasy games have worked in a trilogy, haven't they? I had never really considered it that way because Final Fantasy, you know, 11. I don't really count Final Fantasy 11 as being, you know, one of the main ones. It always bothered me they put the MMOs as, you know, a main one. That's not main to my mind, but whatever. But yeah, I guess there's 1, 2, 3 on NES, 4, 5, 6 on SNES, 7, 8, 9 on PlayStation. The PlayStation ones are always my favorite overall. SNES were still very good, and I really like Final Fantasy X, not X-2. Though X-2 is a really weird one. It has a really great combat system. The gameplay in general is great, except for the fake non-linearity. It has the worst, like, non-linear setup ever. It has all of the missables of non-linear stuff, but it has, like, all of the bad things about linearity regardless. Call me a heretic, but I never played a Final Fantasy game. You don't know where to start? That's the thing about Final Fantasy. I guess if you never played a Final Fantasy... Oh, cursed. Does that mean you can't shoot? I don't know what cursed. Oh, it means we can't use the bell thinger. Okay. Where do we... Okay, let's go heal. One through six were all solid entries. I'm not sure I would go that far. Two is incredibly questionable. Unless you're talking about, like, a remake or something. And one, I really can't recommend any of the NES ones, frankly. Not to a new player, anyway. their history, and they're, you know, important, and they were, you know, in some ways groundbreaking and stuff, but I think for a first game, 4, 6, 7 are the ones. 4, 6, 7, or 10. Maybe not 10. 10's a great game, but it does some things wrong that you wouldn't entirely understand without playing the other ones. And 9 is fantastic, but you can't really recommend 9 as a first one because it calls back to the other ones. Oh, remakes. Are the remakes that good, though? I don't know. I played them a bit on the Game Boy Advance, but I didn't really find them all that enticing, personally. Two had, like, a precursor to the Elder Scrolls method of level-up progress, but it did not work right. It was like, in order to get HP, you had to take hits, and so you would have to, like, basically to level up in that game, you have to have your own party members constantly beat each other up, because there's just no way to properly progress without doing that. It's kind of a mess. You prefer FF3? I don't really have any opinion on 3, honestly. I never really played it. I heard it's really hard, isn't it? I don't know. I'm not the biggest fan of 4, though. Alright, we never went left here. How are you doing, friend? Yeah, I'm not the biggest fan of 4. A lot of people think it's really fantastic. Maybe it's the order that I played them in. I played the Final Fantasy games in a really weird order. 8 was actually... Wait, was it? Yeah, I think 8 was my first one, actually. I started on PlayStation. I had 0 RPGs for the SNES. I did not know that was, like, a thing until PlayStation 1, where I had a lot of RPGs. I did play Super Mario RPG, but I borrowed it from a friend. And it was a very, like, strange game to me, because it was like, what's happening here? Because, you know, it was my first RPG and all that. It is a very good game to have as your first RPG, though. It's kind of made, you know, with that in mind, I suppose. But yeah, I don't really like Final Fantasy IV. It does a lot of interesting things, but the coolest thing it does is mess around with your party and kill off people, but it's so non-committal with how it kills people off, it kind of ruins the effect, and it just ends up being kind of weird. And some of the dramatic high points just kind of pale in comparison, in my opinion, to stuff like Final Fantasy 6, 7, 8. Yeah, it seems so standard, but I guess it kind of set the standard. Maybe, well, I guess the earlier ones, kind of, but I don't know. It just feels... at least if you go backwards, it feels pretty plain. 8's very controversial. It's one of my favorites, though. It's definitely possible to play that game wrong, and it definitely has some design flaws, but it's my favorite world of Final Fantasy. And it's got some really good characters. They're controversial, but I like characters that have, like, reasonable flaws. And, like... Honestly, Squall is kind of just like Cloud, but like an actual human being instead of, you know, whatever Cloud is, you know, just plain old edgy, not really a believable human being. You've yet to play 6, 8, 10, 2, 10, or 13s? Oh, you gotta play 6 and 8. I would say 10, 2 is worth a play if you like ATB. Final Fantasy 10, 2 is like the best implementation of active time battle, in my opinion, and which is very fitting because 10 has the very best of turn-based in the series, so it was a very good set of games gameplay wise I'm not scared. Oh, that was the thing we've been waiting for a long time to read, was just that she's not scared. 10 marked the downfall of the series. It kind of did. Playing it at the time, I was kind of like, hey, What's with this corridor structure? And then 13 got even, you know, did that even worse. And yeah, it kind of does a lot of dumb things. It kind of does mark the beginning of a lot of things that screw up. But, and that's kind of why I rate the PlayStation series as the best one. PlayStation 1 series, that is. But 10 is still worth a play. But you will definitely notice, if you've played the earlier games, you'll notice, hey, what's going on here? What's this? On a different quick note, thanks for joining us. You love this. Oh, you just got it? Oh, glad you like it. It's, I figured I would like it. I just, I was very grumpy at the beginning of this stream, but, I had good reason. You didn't see it, but OBS was being very rude to me. And I have had so many troubles streaming. Just the first sign of an issue streaming makes me want to kill people. So, I'm glad this stream has otherwise gone without hitch, and I'm really glad that Mediacom has fixed their thing. Once they actually started looking at the issue, they've been fine. Oh, it doesn't open from the side. 11. In my opinion, 11 and 14 don't count. I've heard they're great games, but I mean, if you're gonna play all of the Final Fantasy games, I mean, I don't think it counts in that sense. Yeah, 10-2 is really bad story-wise. I don't think anybody will disagree in that sense, but we got an ivory bug. Heck yes. I think 12 is supposed to be 12 is controversial, but the people that like it really like it, which I guess isn't that different from 8, but like, oh, she's still here. Oh, that's so sad. Where am I going? I guess we're just trying to find a thing. Type 0 HD. Oh man, that sucked. I hated that. I got that just for the Final Fantasy 15 demo because it was Gamers Club Unlocked covered it. And the limited edition was okay. The best thing I got out of buying that limited edition was the case. The steelbook with the mono art. I didn't like the game. I didn't like the demo for Final Fantasy 15. I still can't go in there. But yeah, bleh. Oh, and its camera was the fucking worst. And they fixed the camera on PC, but not on console. I'm not sure if they ever went back and fixed it. But the camera in that game was atrocious. Like, offensively bad. Like, I don't even know how you can screw up a camera that bad, but they did. They did with gusto. In Final Fantasy 15, people seem to think it's alright. It doesn't seem like my kind of thing. Type Zero has been on sale for 15 bucks for a long time. That game went cheap really fast. And it's not hard to see why. Oh, hey, John. You haven't been on too many streams lately, have you? It's alright, though. People are busy and stuff. You also have a lot of trouble getting the four Warriors of Light. Yeah, I don't like their Warrior of Light wank. Like, I don't like their interpretation of the Final Fantasy 1 heroes, because it's just, like, made up. Because, like, they weren't really, like, you know, people. They were just kind of character, like, avatars, and, you know, you just gave them stats. I don't think I can go there yet. Nope. I have no idea what I'm doing, to be quite honest. Well, I can't go up this way. Can I go left? No, I can't. Oh, it's a precursor to Bravely Default? Is it? Huh. I still haven't played Bravely Default either. I just kind of avoid RPGs because, you know, even if I like them, that's a lot of time gone, and I try to play as many games as I can, both for the channel and just because, you know, I like a nice diversity of experiences, and, you know, there's some RPG series I really do like, and I'll play everything from them, but, generally, I'd rather play 10 5-hour games than one 50-hour game. As long as the quality is, you know, equivalent. Especially since, you know, it's a lot easier to have you know, it's fairly rare to find a 50-hour game that is, like, where every hour is as good as a good 5-hour game. Sometimes it's nice to grind and, you know, just relax and chill, but I tend to find, like, specific games I chill with. I tend to have one RPG that I'll play at a time. And then, you know, I have some other stuff, like, for a while I was playing, what's that game called? Mercenary Kings. It's slightly it's like Mega Man Monster Hunter-ish, and you build guns and stuff. And it's fairly grindy. You redo a lot of missions if you want to get all of the gun parts and stuff. But it's pretty chill and stuff because of that. So I guess I can't, yeah, need that thing. Where do I go? I guess it's that thing at the top right there. I was expecting to find some door. There's a manga at the... Huh, did they have official characterizations back then? All I know is, like, the fan, like, interpretations of all of the different things. Wait, was there something weird? Oh, no, it's just a candle. I think I was seeing the particles from my, like, dash or something. Wait, can we go down? Oh, the U.S. art for Final Fantasy 1 is, like, really weird. It's, like... it's like Dungeons and Dragons or something, isn't it? Like, not literally, but it looks exactly like it. Final Fantasy 1. Final Fantasy 1 Western box art. That is definitely Final Fantasy 15 and not Final Fantasy 1. What is your problem? Final Fantasy NES Western box art. That's not... I must be thinking of something different. Oh, here we go. It's the Nintendo Power thing. Here we go. It's Final Fantasy, everybody! This is what Final Fantasy looks like, right? Spells, weapons, friends, foes, and maps lead to victory. You know, just your regular Final Fantasy characters. You know, you got your girly boy with the sword there in the middle with the pink or the purple. And you got your old wise man in the background. It's definitely not stolen from a Dungeons and Dragons, you know, guidebook. Nintendo of America is kind of... Oh yeah, it's the weird underwater place. I think FF1 had a beholder, so they had to change. Oh, yeah, that's kind of funny because Final Fantasy 1 actually does have a lot of stuff, like straight out from Dungeons and Dragons. So it's kind of funny that the localization would look so much like the localized art would look so much like Dungeons and Dragons too. But yeah, the beholder is kind of straight up. It's like this is just a Dungeons and Dragons enemy. It has its own flavor at this point, and they call it the Iron Man. Hello there. Finally out of the cell. Should be safe here. This place seems completely abandoned. Now, which way is the forest again? Bloop. Wall of skulls. Huh. What's with those clothes? Who are you? Identify yourself now. Sorry, my falling in from the ceiling tends to startle people. Ah, you're a silent protagonist, huh? Priestess? Okay, then. Here's a friendly warning. You won't find safety in this region anymore. Yeah, I noticed. Maybe the skulls could have tipped me off just a teeny bit. According to hearsay, the queen summoned a storm of disease from her castle, and the one that's spreading throughout the world. Look, you don't seem like a bad person. Thank you. Please run away here from here and save yourself while you can. Whatever. Subterranean cave. It's just where do they get all of these skulls to build an entire cave with? I mean that's a lot of skulls. That requires planning. Oh, don't just repeat your dialogue. I hate when games do that. Like, when I talk to somebody after a cutscene, I want different dialogue. Oh. Oh, it's a cat wizard! Oh, suddenly music. Now, they didn't turn Beholder into Malboro. Malboro is something totally different. I think the first game... Did the first game have Malboro? But nah, they turned Beholder into Araman. Let me show you. I think... I'm not sure if that's a thing in Araman Final Fantasy. Yeah, here's the Final Fantasy. Oh wait, no, it's Crisis Core. Yeah, this is an Araman. It's sort of the more modern... Come on, stretch. It's the modern version of the Beholder. It's still, you know, basically a Beholder, but, slightly less so. And it has its own name. Original character, do not steal. Google's popping up Malboro? Huh. The Araman is what it's... Where? I think that just leads back up. We don't need to go that way. Maybe we want to go in the spooky cave. Well, I don't want to hurt the kitty witch. I'll just leave her alone. How can I help you? Necklace of Sacrifice? Increases attack by 100% when in low health. Increases visibility in dark areas, sure. Oh, I can't afford that thing anyway. Excuse me. Excuse me, there's an obviously fake wall here. Oh, whatever. I guess we gotta go down. No, oh. Ow! Don't just throw a scythe at me. It's rude. Ow! What did I say about throwing scythes at people? What did I just say? Yeah, it's been quite a while since they did that name change, I think. It's usually been Araman. Though some of the early ones, like the place, even up to the FF7, some of the enemies have really weird names. Inconsistent ones. Ah! How dare you curse a treasure chest! Wait, what? Why doesn't my magnetness work? Oh, I should probably equip something more useful or more practical now. Purity flask. That's actually dreadful liquid produced by Tor, the slumbering doctor. Its aroma, though deadly, has charmed many unfortunate souls. Aesthetic value, few know of its secret uses. Oh, right, the Ring of Candor. Oh, hey, drill arrows! I paid a lot of money for that, so I guess I'll use it. Medal of Equivalence. Slowly restores HP. Oh, yeah, that's just... Cursed, now you have cat ears. It took me a second, but yeah. Uh-oh. If I ever make a game, you can bet there's gonna be some Bunny Must Die references in there. Oh. Ow. Cute reflection effect there. Whee! I like the floating table. Makes this place feel very unreal. Oh, look at the little fishes! I love the SNES-style fishies. SNES and PlayStation, like Mega Man 1, or Mega Man Legends, rather, not 1 at all, are kind of my favorite retro aesthetics. Oh, no, I need to go into the thing, but I don't morph ball. Oh, I love this jellyfish. Jellyfish are great. More games need jellyfish. I own 60 jellyfish in, Abyssrium now, just because jellyfish are great. I didn't really know what else to get. It wasn't until 10. By 8, the localization quality has pretty much stabilized, but some names changed around a little bit, even in the late PlayStation era. There we go. Gotta go fast.
Oh no.
I ruined it. If you haven't seen SGDQ, Half Coordinated did a really great run of this. It's a really cool game to see speedrun, and he gave a really great speech too. Is that? I came up here for nothing. Great. Oh no, because I couldn't get. Oh, we're gonna get Morph Ball, aren't we? Wait, no, it wasn't a one way, so maybe it's not Morph Ball. Not yet. But usually, when you see an unusual like. When you see the long way, you have to go the long way around, when you see a little shortcut like that, usually that means you're gonna get the thing that lets you do the thing. Cute little trapdoor thing. There you go. What is, like, gore priestesses? I like that they drop that little thing. Does that hurt you, though? Bulletstorm. Oh, right, the VGAs or whatever are on, aren't they? Oh, boss time. Excuse me! Get that scythe out of here. Get the scythe off the set. We're shooting. Oh, for fuck's sake! You can... Hold... I did not expect that to hurt. Oh, it's a burp druid! He looks very sad. He is not happy about being a burp druid at all. It's like, I hate this job. I have to fight players, and they'll usually kill me, and oh man, this is just really unfortunate for both of us, isn't it? Aw, oh, man. Bulletstorm with Duke Nukem as a playable character? Oh man, why would you deliberately do that to yourself? Aw, oh, man. All due respect to the Duke Nukem series, but no. No, honey. That IP is basically toast. Is he getting thinner? Or is that just my imagination? Slender burb. Doing the crotch laser. Oh, wait, why does he have stuff on him now? Is he laying a clutch of eggs or something? Ow. That might be dropping? Huh? Hold on. I've dropped 0.6% of frames. I might have dropped a bunch in a row or something, but I'm not currently dropping any. Bulletstorm was so perfect, and then they added Duke Nukem. Wait, what? Bulletstorm, isn't that like 8, like, almost 10 years old? Like, this is a PlayStation 3 game, right? PlayStation 3 era. Aw. Sad Burb even had a sad, like, death animation. Like, nothing too fancy. You added a crest fragment. Its essence grants you the ability to charge arrows faster. Heck yeah! In addition to the feature that I keep forgetting even exists in any capacity, I will surely use it greatly. Oh yeah, I've been streaming this whole time. Didn't Beam tell you? I hate that, like, I thought Beam was supposed to, like, reload if it had an issue, but... If you see people talking in chat, just hit F5, because the stream is probably still on. Bulletstorm Full Clip Edition? Oh. So, a remaster then? Wait, remaster remake, though. Because that's... different. I can't imagine they would do a full-on remake or reboot, because, like, full clip, it, like, if Edition is in there, it's a remake, or it's a remaster. Hey, Kaho, help me somehow. Who are you? I guess you're just dead. This looks like, what, this looks like a human peep, or something. Like, what is this? Also, you're a skeleton. What do you care? Wait, how do I... Oh, I see. What? Hey. Oh, you have to attack it. There you go, friend. I did the thing. It doesn't fix itself unless you refresh. I thought it was supposed to if it dropped frames, but I don't know. Just refresh if you see issues generally. Thank you. I was imprisoned here and feared all hope was lost. Cough! Don't cough on me, you jackass! Now I can resume my search for my wife. We both died. He is a skeleton! I knew it! And yet it seems the dead have crossed the border towards this world. So much left untold. I plan to reunite with her and escape this forsaken city. I can see you are still in one thick piece. What kind of attire you use? It's not something from this land, am I correct? Cough. No matter. What are you coughing with? You're a skeleton. At this state of decay, none of us should be idling carelessly. I'll be around. Take care. Ah! The dead bird creature is, like, still trapped. Rest in peace, dead bird creature. I guess there's some unexplored stuff to the left. Uh-oh. Ooh! That was close. How long has it been since I've saved? On back to the wall. Oh, there was a thing this way. Okay. I did not notice that at all. Wait, is there a save thing somewhere? I should probably go save. I want that thing! Okay, so we can go down or we can go right. Let's go down, I guess. Down spooky spike pit. Oh dang, 2 hours already. I probably won't play this a ton longer. It's been a tiring week. Well, I haven't been going to sleep early enough, I guess, is part of it. So I'll probably try to crack that today. Inspect. Got garden key! Not sure what it's doing under like 5,000 feet of water, but whatever. Those do not hurt as much as I would have thought from how they look. And from how reasonably easily they're avoided. Oh! Good thing we went that way first! Oh, back to Whiteleaf Memorial Park, apparently. What are you? Oh, I thought these two things... I thought this was, like, some sort of, like, horrible red corpse, but it's, like, a tree root and then a thing behind it. Funny how pixel art can be kind of ambiguous like that sometimes. Ah, I knew secrets would be there. Can't hide your secrets from me. Pokemon Go won best mobile/handheld? Ugh. Did they pick that winner like 4 months ago back when it was actually relevant? Or how did that happen? Remember when Pokemon Go was going to like rechange how like cities are built? And like everything in the world was going to be Pokemon Go? And then like... people are like, oh, it's just, you know, it doesn't really have that much longevity. Okay. Uh-oh. Speaking of not much longevity, these platforms. Of course you're... is that the cousin that throws his PlayStation controllers? Because people call them a duty in the Call of Duty? Oh, hey, there's a Switch! I want the Switch! Well, of course that guy wants wait, this is the thing! This is that other place that we saw. Okay, hold on. Aw, no, it locks you in! How dare you! There we go. What did that do, though? Yeah, Pokemon Go had a lot of questionable stuff going on. But, you know, it was a big fad, so of course, you know. And I mean, it had, you know, it had appeal. But its amazingness was greatly overstated. Bulbasaur's like Gears of War in South Park. I'm not sure that's inaccurate, but... yeah. I love that the arrows are kind of angled. That's a really cool touch. I figured that would open that shortcut there. So yeah, we've opened a path between... possibly these three areas? Where does this go? Oh, Bunny Lady! Hi, Bunny Lady! Why do you keep jumping in front of the person you're talking to? You may have noticed parts of the cities have been affected by a foul curse. Such as all of the parts. This area in particular has been displaced and is now corrupted by spirits of the dead. So my dear plants have dried to the soulless form. I've been looking for this rare oh, here's where we need the ivory bugs. If you happen to come across one of those, please bring it to me. I'll reward you in any way I can. Oh my. I see you've found the special bug I've told you about. Here, take this reward. Aw, it's just Muns? I have two of them, I think. Eh, whatever. What a horrible nice to have your curse. Oh! Here we go, yep. Like I said, it's a, like, three-way shortcut. I like that. I like when shortcuts are more than just, like, one way, because it... The problem too many Metroid shortcuts have is that you really need to be going along from a certain place to a certain place. It's not really... It doesn't always make the world feel necessarily open. I mean, well, in a good Metroid game it does, but more like... I'm talking about, like, Metroid Fusion. Metroid Fusion's shortcuts aren't... They're not really shortcuts. They're like odd one way. Well, not always one way, but they're odd, very specific things. My dear Cecilia. It's very strange seeing a skeleton like mourn at a grave. Gav is giving a speech about how Konami mistreated his employees. That's amazing. Yeah, they didn't let... If you didn't know, last Game Awards, Konami did not let Kojima go. And he won an award, and he could, like, go and get it. Because Konami just is terrible. I don't know what their problem is. I'd be surprised if Konami's still around in 5 years. They probably would be, but probably just as, you know, a casino company. Or a don't call it gambling company, rather. Oh my god. Wait. I'm not actually that far back. Oh wait. Yes, I am. God damn it. I'm kind of surprised that Keisha, like, that in Mega Dimension, they didn't, like, rip on Keisha, like, incessantly, but maybe. I don't know, maybe they thought that was too mean, or maybe, like, I don't know, I guess they're not really... If anything, they're meanest to the main characters, not really the makers. Yeah, if there was any ever a time, it was a bit, it would be completely deserved. Yeah. Weird how stuff like pachinko keeps getting past Japanese gambling laws, because I mean, it's very bald-faced what it is, but there's like, they design things exactly to get around the laws, and like, then nobody cares, and it's like, got bellflower. Oh hey, we have even more bellflowers. So yeah, I guess, yeah, this is some definite Souls stuff going on, I guess. I'm not really the biggest fan of it, but it's alright. It does its job, but it doesn't really feel... Oh, Dull Pearl. 10th house. Ooh, poison properties to your arrows! Oh, that's awesome. Oop. Wait, is this a Smeakrit? No, it's just weird thing. Okay. Sega doesn't really release that many video games, though, so I wouldn't really be surprised. Oh, hey, Titty Witch. Oh, ow. That sounds like a Kirby sound effect there, when they come out of the ground. Hey, Zealot. But yeah, Sega not earning as much from video games, and I think Konami had the same. You might actually be thinking of Konami, because I definitely heard that about Konami. But it doesn't mean so much when you, like, only release a few video games and, like, 18 billion pachinko things, and then you make more money on pachinko. It's like, oh, I wonder why that happened. What's this? Momodora 5. Oh, frick. I forgot to change. Wait, no, I think I changed the game. It should be the game's name on, on Twitch. I thought I fixed it. But yeah, this is the current, chrono.gg game. Which, if you didn't know, they're like this service that they have daily game deals and you can redeem it on Steam. Yeah, it's Momodora 4. Why would you think that's 5? Like, I could see mistaking that Roman numeral for 6, but 5 is very clear. Speaking of the aren't the Final Fantasy, the PlayStation Final Fantasies numbered all weird? Like, I think 8 specifically has the wrong number. Like, shouldn't it just be IIX instead of VIII? Or are those equally, or is that correct? I don't know. But I thought you were supposed to do as few symbols as possible. Because otherwise you could do, like, IIIX instead of VI. But whatever. Oh, there's a new trailer for that upcoming Kojima game. Now with 99% more clothing. No. Why did you kill me? You can't cutscene kill me. How dare you? Why am I a cat? It really is the curse from Bunny Must Die. I'm a freaking cat. Okay. Well, I love that attack effect. Oh, she has got the leaf in her mouth. And she's got a little thing around her tail. Very good, Kit. Parker of the game. Eight, nine, ten would be VVX. But why isn't IIX? Why isn't that 8? Can still double jump as a cat. Ah, for Pete's sake. Like, why did the Witch of Decay turn me into a cat? Like, that's not really what I would associate with decay. You got an ivory bug! Wait, being a cat is morph ball? Oh my gosh! That is the cutest dodge roll ever. Uh-oh. Oh, we made kitty sounds! Whee! Best dodge graphics ever. Yeah, apparently the video game awards are going on, and I don't tend to watch those anyway, so I don't personally really mind missing that for the stream. But if you want to watch it, go ahead. I won't, you know. No hard feelings. Is there a point to fighting? She does way too many reaction frames. Smeakrits? I knew it! Hello, friend. I can't tell if she's eating an apple or if she has one of those, like, red bondage orbs in her mouth. Oh, I'm sorry! Her cake. I don't have cake. How do I get her cake? Crystal seed. Oh. I could have used that thing. I didn't realize that wasn't a passive item. You'd love to see me play Dot Flow? I would love to play Dot Flow too, but Dot Flow does not want to be played. Why can we hurt the cute thing? It's not hurting anybody. I hate when games let you hurt innocent things like that. Like, they always feel bad, and I usually, like, especially when you don't do it on purpose, like, ow. Yeah, there's nothing worse than hurting something on accident in a game. Inspect. Got Cat Sphere! Heck yes! What is Cat Sphere? Cat Sphere. Alternates between- oh! Okay. Object of unknown sorcery. So it's that easy to uncat yourself. What a pathetic curse. It lasted for like 5 minutes, and it gave me an amazing new power. That's like one of the curses from Paper Mario, Thousand Year Door. Like, let me just curse you with less, like, oh my gosh! This is your crouch animation! This is the best game ever. Best crouch. Get that out of here. Nope. That's awesome. I love the, like, 16-bit cat sound. It's not, like, just a recorded cat sound. It's, you know, it's a chiptune cat. Were the cursed chests actually trying to help you, though? I thought they were just, like, really bad at cursing was the deal. No titty witch. Oh! I guess we can't go that way anyway. Will you talk to a cat? She doesn't care that I'm a cat. Aw, cats can't use ladders. Really nice moody music here. I don't know where I'm going. Wait. I haven't gone up? I think probably everybody that's going to play Thousand Year Door has played it by now. Wait, wasn't I here? Oh yeah, I was here, I just didn't use that particular passageway to get here. Alright, that's just this guy with his Cecilia. I do like the grayed out text to indicate... I've seen other games do that, but it's still neat. Do they? I never got that out of the game. I didn't know that. An old roof dwelling fortune teller tells that? Huh. Yeah, we heard your shtick, bunny. Just have you bugs. There's a dog in Breath of the Wild. Doesn't that just let you summon Wolf Link, which is really weird? You know. Having two Links, one of which is a dog, is like totally normal, but you know. Female? Human female Link? I don't think so. Wait. Can we attack the burb as the kitty? This is important. Aw. I look like a Persian, don't I? I look like an off-brand Persian. Now the enemies fight the... That's neat, I guess. Wait, were you here before? Prayers have been heard. The Witch of Decay and her demons have been vanquished. Little by little, the voice of the gods pierced through this kingdom, shrouded in darkness. Still, since covenant to go against Her Highness's witchiness is a disgrace to the name of our Lord. Her kindness knows no bounds. If you so desire, she'll protect even a heretic from Lun such as you. Pfft. Whatever, sister. literal sister since you're some kind of stupid nun. Oh wait, we had an idle animation there. I want to see the idle animations. Just a classic yawn. Is there only one? Do your idle. Let's see the cat idle. Do the idle. Aww. I really like the animations in this game. Alright, let's go. I think this is the key. Yeah, we can use keys as a cat. Ow! Hey! What's Thousand Year Door? Paper Mario, the Thousand Year Door. It's, Paper Mario RPG. It's also the last Paper Mario game. I guess Super's alright, but it's not really. Eh. I still begrudge Super. Uh-oh, boss time. The Queen destroyed this kingdom's faith. This covenant. Oh, she's gonna turn around and her face is gonna be all spooky. This covenant, our abode, is all that's left here for those who pray. Oh. You have a normal face. Maiden in white. I'm actually a cat. Excuse you. Do not disgrace my people. Do not presume that I am human. I am a cat, and I am very proud of my peoples. Are you perhaps siding with the queen? Look at what she's done to this kingdom. I'm not siding with the queen, I'm gonna go kill her. I think. Hey. Hey, don't you use your blood sword on me, pal. It's my duty to expurge that evil. Just, hey, I'm not gonna, hey, whoa. Pardon her. Hey, you're supposed to be nice. Partners are supposed to be nice. Don't make me the cat kick your ass. Ow. Don't you air dash at me. You're not even on the... She air dashed and she's not even in the air. Oh, look at those legs and that roll animation. Really love the animations in this. You are attacking a cat with a blood sword. Calm your tits. What are you doing? Are you having an episode? This game would be even better if the cutscene things were different when you were a cat and they're like, what? Yeah, I don't know. This medication is not working out. I probably could have dealt with this on normal mode, but you know, like I was saying earlier, it just, why, my lord? Because you attacked me! Aww. Well, that's what happens when you attack random cats. I'm cursed, so I can't use my item. Awkward silence. Okay, here we go. You found a crest fragment. Its essence grants you the ability to renew bow charge level. Ooh! That feature that I keep forgetting to use got even better. Ooh! That's significantly more useful. I just get the image of somebody giving a huge dramatic speech and it just cuts to a cat grooming itself. One of? I mean... Oh, for fuck's sake! My pinky toe touched a spike and I exploded. Like, video game spikes, like, it's okay when they make sense, but like... I hate when you can walk into them from the side like that. Like, that's just dumb. Like, in some games, they'll do it so that you can't... Like, if you walk into them from the side, you know, you're just rubbing up against a blunt wall, basically. So it won't hurt you, but... Whatever. I mean, Paper Mario 64 is good, but... I wouldn't say it's as good as Thousand Year Door, unless you like things really simple. Ugh. Sonic is a bit hit or miss on that. I think Sonic usually lets you hit the wall or hit the edge of the spikes. And if you can't, usually in Sonic, like, the spikes in Sonic Adventure, they're at least low enough that you can tell that's probably not gonna, you know, give you a pass. So I have, wait, do I have three or map completion 61%? I really don't. I don't have time to finish this tonight. I might stream the rest of it some other time. I'm not sure about tomorrow. Oh dang, we're dropping frames. We're dropping a lot of frames. Okay. I'm actually about done for the night. So since we're dropping frames, I'm gonna go ahead and call it a night here. I'm gonna find. Yeah, I'm just gonna head to the save point. I hope you can hear me. Cause like, I'm dropping like everything according to the stupid, son of a bitch. Stop dropping frames. Well, as always, if the recording is too bad, I'll just upload my local copy. But yeah, if you want to play this, or buy this, it's 35% off on, Chrono GG. You can go through that link. And, yeah, disclosure, that's an affiliate link, obviously, as it has my name in it, which I kind of like that about Chrono GG's affiliate system. It's very upfront and easy to use. But, yeah, thanks for watching, everybody. Good night. I'll probably stream the rest of this at some point, but not tonight. And from the good nights, I'll assume that I'm at least audible. But, yeah, we were going so well. And I didn't even expect the drop frames problem to come back. But like I said, that should be fixed ideally tomorrow. Maybe if it's not by Monday, I have to talk to MediaCom again. But hopefully stream should be better starting this weekend. And I guess it makes sense to stream tomorrow to double check. But yeah, good night.